Hey y'all. This is Dolce, the beautiful black female Cane Corso, very dominant. And then the gray brindle one right there is Lucia. She's 1 year old Cane Corso puppy. And then little Gypsy is the pit bull in the middle there. And they are just kind of playing with this sock, this old sock that I had. I was going to throw it away, but yeah. So what happens is that Dolce, and she loves to spar. Dolce loves to spar with Lucia, and Gypsy gets in the way of that. See, Gypsy kind of wards off Dolce. And this is play growling. I learned to know the difference. See, Lucia is still in play mode. But look how Dolce, look how Gypsy the pit bull is kind of fending off. She's trying to control Dolce, who's very dominant. And a lot of times, Gypsy will seemingly try to protect her best bud there, Lucia, from Dolce, because Dolce takes kind of a disciplinary, almost maternal role toward Lucia. She corrects Lucia often when Lucia is too excited, which is good. But when that happens, Gypsy will try and get in the way of it. See her? See her? She's like, all right, Lucia, I got rid of her. Dolce. Dolce. So, yeah, those are my two females that are very dominant. To really keep a close eye on them. And Lucia is just kind of more happy-go-lucky. They're gonna take this outside. She said, meet me outside, how about that? Yeah, they're gonna. And then this is Ozzy. Lucia! Ozzy's my alpha male, if you're new to that kid pack. Lucia! Oh. See, usually Dolce will come shut that down. She'll correct to get the names right. Dolce will usually come and correct Lucia for getting in Ozzy's face like that. But I guess she's taking a potty break outside. So she did briefly. She got into his face. Gypsy. Anyways, just a kind of laid-back morning here. Getting some stuff done on the computer. Oh, I got to do laundry. Oh, Lord. Yeah, so these are their doggy beds, and that I often have. You very rarely, I guess, in my videos will see what they really look like. These are also removable covers. But because I usually have a sheet, I just washed and bleached these sheets. I usually have a sheet on them for when I will feed them a chew toy or anything that's gonna get these beds dirty. They're usually covered. And I gotta wash this thing too. It's getting dirty. This couch is pretty forgiving. It's real leather. It's a soft leather. So any of these kind of nicks and stuff, they just buff right out. Lucia! She's very curious. What's going on? Hi, baby girl. Isn't she beautiful, y'all? But yeah, so, but I just try to, you know, cover them with, just to kind of prevent wear and tear as much as I can, but, and then I wash these every week. So that's what I'm doing today, washing bedding. Hi, pretty girl. Hi, Lucia. Lucia is the only one that does this. She kind of self-stacks herself. She wants to be in the middle of everything. She wants to know what's going on. My baby girl. Ah, see. Hi, Papa. Yeah. Anyway, just checking with in with everybody to say hi and oh, you're gonna get in trouble. Lucia, that's enough. Lucia! Get out of his face. No, no. You settle down. Good girl. See, she takes correction very well. She's just so excited around Ozzy. Yeah, Lucia, you know, she's in that age range where she could mate soon. And she's kind of, you know, hormones are high for her. Over a year. She's over a little over a year, so she's of that age. I liken it to like a teenage girl, early 20s or teens. You know, they're full of hormones. They're excited. And Ozzy's the only, like, you know, he's the big man on campus. My other male is Tux. He's a pit bull mix. Let me see if I can find Tux. Hi, baby boy. So we're just waking up. But Tux, even though he's a male, Lucia's not at all interested in Tux, because Tux is the most docile dog. He's kind of the lowest ranking member of the pack as far as the hierarchy structure. Where's Tux? No, he's not in here. He's not in here. Let's see, where is Tux? He's probably outside. But anyways, you've seen him if you watched the channel before. But yeah, so Ozzy and Tux are my two males. But yeah, these two play amicably. There's no, I don't ever see any risk of a fight. Although never say never, right? But it's because of the personalities, the temperaments. Lucia is not very confrontational. She's not a pushover. I mean, she'll put up a good challenge, but she's not like wanting to fight, you know, like potentially Dolce will. And she's middle of the road, Lucia. She's not a lowest ranking. She's not a highest ranking. As far as temperament and structure and hierarchy, she's middle. She's middle. She's confident and I guess more or less even-tempered. Whereas Dolce is high energy and intense and dominant, extremely dominant. As far as dominance, you know, tendencies go, as far as, you know, kind of Corso go, she's very dominant even for a Corso. Yeah, but temperaments within kind of Corso, they range. It's a spectrum. They can be very laid back to kind of even-tempered and to very dominant. But just by the fact that, you know, it's a kind of Corso, that the dog is going to be dominant to a certain degree, which Lucia is. Like I said, she's confident, she's dominant in her own right, but compared to Dolce, Dolce is more dominant. I like to use the word intense. Dolce is just intense. Lucia, you know, she's like, she doesn't back down per se, but she doesn't, like, persist and want to, you know, fight for a sock, you know. She'll let something go if it's going to be a fight. But she does stand her ground when she needs to. And I think that's the perfect temperament. And that's what I'm looking for. That's what Ozzy is, too. Ozzy's an alpha dog. But he's very even-tempered. He's very stable. He's not going to go try and, like Dolce will try and almost like seemingly want to pick a fight, instigate the dogs to challenge her because she's just that intense. Ozzy won't do that. But anyways, y'all, let's see. This is a almost 10-minute video. Ozzy. I think most of my videos have been between 20, 30 minutes. I might have a 1-hour video out there somewhere. But this one's going to be a little bit shorter just because I got a lot of stuff I got to get done. And I was just sitting here doing some work on the computer and I saw that interaction between the three females. And I wanted to show y'all and talk about that for a minute.
And so that interaction between the three of them, you could see it was kind of heating up a little bit. And the biggest risk there that I can see is a fight breaking out between the pit bull Gypsy there and Dolce, the dominant black female. So I think that, you know, if it had escalated anymore, I would have stepped in.
Come on, Dolce, come this way.
I would have stepped in and de-escalated that. So I gotta keep a close eye on them. And luckily, when I'm not in the house, when I'm at work, they're sleeping. They're not like in play mode like this. They're usually sleeping. But see, already Dolce's coming in there. She's wanting to take that sock away. It's a game to her. But she likes a good challenge. See, she's growling already. Hovering over Lucia to show dominance. And see now how Gypsy's coming in? Corralling Dolce. Like trying to get her away from Lucia and trying to show her, no, you got to go through me if you're going to get to Lucia. That's how I'm interpreting her body language. Yes, she's hovering over Dolce. Gypsy is. Very interesting. And see how Lucia's just like, hey, I don't want no trouble here. Let's keep it playful. And now, if Lucia had the same temperament as Dolce, that would be extremely volatile. I wouldn't, probably wouldn't keep two females that are like Dolce. And I specifically picked Lucia from a litter because she had the temperament that was kind of even keel and stable, not extremely intense. You know, because I knew I had Dolce. Dolce. So it's very intense. Girls. Gypsy! Get back. I'm going to have to start correcting Gypsy. You know, Gypsy, she's not doing anything. She's the one growling, actually. Gypsy's the one growling. She's not doing anything wrong, per se, but, oh, she's showing her teeth even. But she is, it actually kind of works a little bit. See, now this is interesting. Dolce actually responded to that from Gypsy. She kind of backed off a little bit. Gypsy's kind of trying to be like the mediator here. Like, no, Dolce, you're not getting this sock. This is between Lucia and I. But I do have a video that I posted.
Hey, shh. Get back. See how Gypsy's now?
And Dolce,
Hey, Gypsy, it's enough. Gypsy's dominant, y'all.
And Dolce is not looking for a fight today. She actually responded well to that. Good girl, Dolce. Good girl, Dolce. Good girl. Good girl, my Dolce. Dolce, good.
That was good. And see, now the two of them are gonna play with that sock without any risk of a fight, really.
Dolce. Interesting, huh? It's a very, very tight rope that I'm walking there with Gypsy. She is a pit bull. She's 100% American Pitbull Terrier. And, you know, that it's a generalized statement, but pit bulls are known to not back down. It's just their breed, the way that they were bred. It's in their genetics. They don't back down very easily. So I think that's what we're seeing there. So I really have to kind of mediate that, monitor that.
Hi, Papa. Hi, baby boy.
And so far, I have not had any fights break out or anything like that. I do have two tasers. One that looks like a flashlight, but it's got a taser function and an extremely loud noise. And then I've also got this taser here, a little bit more powerful. These are always within reach. I take these outside with me.
This I like this one at night because it's also a flashlight. Yeah, I take them outside with me when we go, you know, out in the back, and sparring sessions happen out there in the area that I call the mosh pit. And so if the event ever happened that there was a fight, then I could use that. And I think it would be successful in breaking it up. If not the extremely loud noise, then the taser function would be helpful. But the key is really to keep the energy at a minimum, because you can prevent a fight by controlling the energy. So anyways, y'all, that's a little bit on that. Comment down below if you've had similar, if you have similar dynamics in your pack and what you do. And yeah, just let me know what y'all are thinking. And thanks again for watching. Also, I want to put out there again, if I know I'm behind on answering some of your comments and questions, I'm getting to that. That's on my to-do list as well today. Got a few things I got to do. And yeah, so again, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and we'll see you on the next one.
Ozzy. Hi, Papa. You were sleeping, honey. Were you sleeping? Hi, Papa. You were sleeping. Ozzy.